How far am I willing to go for victory? But now we bring you to the first part of my name, suicidal. I am willing to go further than my opponent to win. If I have to use myself as a weapon, I'll do it. If I have to jump off something, if I have to spring off something, whenever it may be, if I have to launch and propel myself to do damage, if I have to hurt me to hurt them more, then so be it.
Coming out to the ring now is the Suicydal Soulja, a fan favorite. Now, Suicydal is going to face off against Jael for this Pride Championship.
Yeah, Jael Rose going to defend his Pride Championship against the Suicydal Soulja. Suicydal Soulja able to beat Jael Rose the last time these two met, one by countout. Can Suicydal get it done tonight?
That's a good question. Now, last time he did technically get that victory, but it was not a pinfall. And then, of course, after the fact, Paul Jordane became involved. Lots of inner workings between Waylon Barley, Jael Rose, Paul Jordane, Suicydal Soulja. But tonight is just a one-on-one match. Now, if Suicydal can't get this victory, it really brings into question how much longer he should be considered for this Pride title.
Well, it really does. This is his second shot at the title. And it'll be interesting tonight to see if he can get it done. He's, like I said, he done it last time by countout. Can he get the victory tonight against a much larger, much bigger Jael Rose?
Well, Suicydal Soulja, of course, always has the advantage of having that high-flying style. That's what's given him a lot of great success in the past, and that's what catapulted him to the top of the Pride rankings to get a shot at this title. But this is really going to be the deciding match. Suicydal Soulja needs to have a decided clean victory to make sure that he gets that title on his belt, that title belt on him tonight, so that he walks away with what he was hoping for.
Well, it really is. It's a do or die situation for the Suicydal Soulja. Suicydal Soulja has to come away with a victory tonight.
Absolutely. But the man he's facing off against, Jael Rose, is not going to make it easy for him.
No, he's not. Jael Rose, NHW Heavyweight Champion, NHW Pride Champion. Jael Rose, very talented athlete, not going to make it easy for the Suicydal Soulja at all. Suicydal going to have his hands full with Jael Rose.
Absolutely. In the ring is the Suicydal Soulja. Coming out is Jael Rose, and he is not looking happy. He is still upset over that loss last time, though technically by disqualification, still a loss on his record. And if JL can't come away with the victory tonight, that's going to truly cause some concern in him as he moves forward September 9th and faces off against Paul Jordane for that heavyweight bout.
Well, it really does, and it says something for JL Rose. This is a do-or-die match for JL Rose also. JL lost the last time these two met, and really needs to win this match. I mean, he can lose and walk out with his title, but what does that say for Jael Rose? Jael Rose has to win tonight also. A do or die for both competitors.
Well, it doesn't change the fact that he will have at least one championship at the end of the night, but it more does something for his psyche, because coming into his next match with a loss would do a lot to make him reconsider his actions and the way he's been doing it. But Jael Rose seems to be pretty confident, if not fairly irritated, to be having to come out and do this.
And Jael Rose accompanied by Justin Micheals. And again, that leads me to believe the Suicydal Soulja will have his hands full with Justin Micheals and Jael Rose.
Justin Micheals, always a bit of a wrench in the plans for Suicydal Soulja.
First of all, hey Kool-Aid, you are the worst ring announcer I have ever heard.
Please, and gentlemen, you have no choice.
What?
But
Justin Michaels trying to get the crowd pumped up on JL's side, but they're still not having any of it. These fans love Suicydal Soulja.
They do. Suicydal Soulja slapped Justin Michaels. A bit of an exchange between those two moments ago.
Suicydal Soulja clearly getting frustrated by the constant mouthing off from Justin Michaels, being the mouthpiece, making sure that the fans know exactly how JL feels, and the fans have made it clear how they feel about him.
Well, they really have. Referee right now checking out Jael Rose as he seems to be, something's on his mind.
Well, there's a lot of things going through his mind. Before the show started, he thought Paul Jordane was going to be nowhere near this area. Now, Paul Jordane is in the building, having surprised everyone by coming out earlier in that Bullet Bob match. So he has to deal with someone who has interfered in the past and someone who he won his championship from.
Someone he took that championship from. He didn't win it. He got it. And Suicydal, the bell rings, and immediately Suicydal Soulja on the attack. Two drop kicks. Has the champion down. Wow!
Immediate display of athleticism from Suicydal Soulja. Very impressive.
And the Suicydal Soulja, high-flying extraordinaire, takes to the air immediately and tries to get JL up. Not strong enough. JL with an Irish whip, and Soulja off those ropes catches JL with right hands. Wow, Soulja puts on the brakes, hangs on, trips up JL, dumps him out of the ring. And Soulja,
oh my gosh,
wow.
That is insanity.
What a move as Suicydal Soulja, suicide dive to pay con Hilo with the backflip. Wow, nice move from the Suicydal Soulja.
The man must be one quarter helium balloon because that just defied all logic.
And gravity.
Gravity doesn't exist to Suicydal Soulja, and JL knows that, so he is pacing around this ring, doesn't want to get back in, a bit shaken up from that display of athleticism.
And JL Rose making his way back into the ring, and Suicydal immediately on the attack. And Suicydal catches him with a big right knee, and another knee has JL Rose reeling.
Suicydal getting very excited, pumping up the crowd.
And JL Rose caught him that time, has the leg of the Soulja, flips him up. Wow, what a move. And Soulja again flips around, has him by the legs. JL got out of that, picks up the Soulja very easily. Wow.
Oh. That just goes to show the strength that JL Rose has compared to Suicydal Soulja. Really, when you see these two men in the ring, you start to understand the comparisons of David versus Goliath. It's quite the challenge for Suicydal to overcome tonight.
It really is. JL Rose, big, massive competitor. There you just seen the strength of JL Rose easily picking up the Suicydal Soulja and slamming him down on the mat. And again, hooks him, has him high up in the air. Wow, high vertical suplex from JL Rose.
And you can absolutely see the pain that comes from a move like that on the face of Suicydal Soulja, wincing at such a harsh blow.
Yeah, Suicydal Soldier's in a lot of pain. JL Rose up crowing about his handiwork, bragging.
JL is absolutely proud of what he's doing, and he's ready to do a whole lot more.
And has the Soulja hooked, has him up now high, another high vertical suplex.
Really just trying to decimate the Suicydal Soulja. JL Rose showing off his impressive feats of strength. Doesn't seem to be even breaking a sweat doing this.
JL Rose having his way with the Suicydal Soulja thus far.
And having some words with the ref, too. Not too happy that he's there with him.
And JL again hooks the head of Suicydal Soulja. And again, a third high vertical suplex from JL Rose. Suicydal Soulja on the mat and in a lot of pain.
And the fans are not happy one bit, but JL seems very happy and proud of himself for what he's doing, almost toying with the Suicydal Soulja at this point.
Jael Rose showing that strength, and Suicydal showing that second effort, fighting his way out of it. And off the ropes, and wow, caught hard with a big elbow from the champion, Jael Rose.
Jael Rose, the dual champion, is a monstrous man and proves every time he gets in the ring why he has those championship belts.
He goes for a cover that time, got a two count. Just kneeling down across the chest of the soldier.
JL and Justin Michaels couldn't look happier with the situation.
JL Rose taking his time with his competitor. And has him up high again. And has the soldier up, parades around the ring with him.
Showboating with him like he's just a toy. That is a large man he has on his back. This is no small feat of strength, but JL Rose makes it look exceptionally easy.
JL Rose still has him up on his shoulder. Wow, slams him down hard. And Suicydal Soulja hit the mat really hard, and he is shaken up.
And JL seems very confident that at this point, he has this match in the bag. He is really trying to make up for the fact that he got the loss last time and has a certain fire about him and just a certain anger towards the Suicydal Soulja that he may not have had in the past.
Definitely seems JL Rose is highly motivated. That time got a two count. Hooks the arm again, now hooks the leg. Suicydal coming back. And JL Rose slips into a rear chin lock. Referee checking the airway, making sure he's not in a chokehold. JL Rose tightening down the pressure on the Suicydal Soulja. And Soldier got to his feet, but JL Rose takes him over, headlock takeover. Right back down on the canvas goes the Suicydal Soulja.
Once again, showing that domination with his pure strength, Suicydal Soulja has to get out of this before it becomes a very dangerous situation for him.
JL Rose on top of him, dominating thus far, using that size and strength to his advantage. And Suicydal Soulja trying to get his way out of it, dropped a jawbreaker, hit JL Rose square on the jaw. And Justin Michaels interfered that time, grabbed the Soulja, and Soulja just got upended by JL Rose.
Once again, Suicydal Soulja not realizing that Justin Michaels is around and is a factor. If he spends any time not focused on both threats to him, he is going to slip up just like that.
And again, the referee being distracted as Justin Michaels with some cheap shots on the Suicydal Soulja.
Well, if it's a shot that the ref can't see, who am I to say that it's cheap?
It's a shot that I seen very clearly.
The ref starts his count. Last time, Jael Rose won that match by disqualification due to a timeout. See if that happens again.
And this time, JL Rose with a hard right forearm that took the soldier to the canvas.
Now just getting some words of encouragement from Justin Michaels, ready to keep this match going. Justin Michaels exchanging words with the ref knowing that something might be amiss when it comes to Justin Michaels' managerial style.
And checking out both competitors. JL Rose making his way back into the ring. As the crowd tries to get behind the Suicydal Soulja.
The support of the fans is wonderful, but it doesn't do you much good when you're facing off against a man the size of Jael Rose.
At 6'4", 250 pounds, Jael Rose, a massive competitor. And right now in control of the Suicydal Soulja.
Deciding what he wants to do with the Suicydal Soulja exactly. He has him in the palm of his hand. It's just up to him where he goes from here. Normally, the high-flying top rope maneuvers are left to the Suicydal Soulja, not Jael Rose.
But both of them are on those ropes. Suicydal hanging on to that top rope. Pounding away on Jael Rose. Both of them still on those second rope. Suicydal going to the top now on a third rope. Wow!
Both men now down after that move. Ref starts his 10 count. See if either of these men can get up in time.
And referee counting them down.
Justin Michaels furious at the side of the ring, trying to do anything he can to help motivate Jael Rose to get back up. Suicydal Soulja having the motivation of the fans cheering him on.
Both men still down, unable to get back on their feet thus far. A war between these two. And Soldier wailing away on Jael Rose. Jael still on his feet and reversed the Irish whip. Went for a clothesline, missed. Suicydal has him up and drops him hard down on the mat. Suicydal Soulja, nice move.
When it comes to moves like that, you have to wonder if Jael Rose is starting to get a bit fearful. He knows his ranking as a dual champion will no longer count if he loses this match tonight. And having lost before a Suicydal Soulja, he may be worried.
Well, he could be. A lot on the mind of JL and Suicydal. Suicydal went for a cover. Only got a one count on the Pride champion. That title on the line tonight, the Pride belt, currently held by the outlaw JL Rose on the line. As Suicydal Soulja doing his best to try to get it. Man, nice move by the Suicydal cross block off the ropes. And with a nice kick and winds him up down. Another nice move from the Suicydal Soulja.
And you can start to see the concern on Justin Michaels' face. Just the Suicydal Soulja is starting to gain some momentum.
This match is starting to turn. Suicydal Soulja gaining momentum. Jael Rose and Justin Michaels. Justin Michaels looks on kind of worried. And Jael just dumped him up. Suicydal didn't go out, though. Jael thought he did. Turns around. Wow, referee got caught in it.
The referee appears to be knocked out cold. Suicidal's high-flying maneuver missed his mark. Now the ref is out. No one can keep track of what's happening in the ring, and Jael knows that.
Referee is down. Jael Rose just dropped the Suicydal Soulja. And Justin Michaels pointing out the down referee.
Bit of a moment of contemplation on the part of Jael Rose, knowing that there are no rules to be enforced. Justin Michaels encouraging him, passing him his championship belt to use possibly as a weapon.
Jael Rose has that belt in his hand. That Pride Championship belt. Referee Daniel Johnson still face down on the mat, is not moving.
Justin Michaels knows this full well, holds on to Suicydal Soulja. Oh, God. Again.
Wait a minute. Paul Jordane face to face with Jael Rose. And Suicydal Soulja just took out Justin Michaels. Jael, he's waiting. He's waiting. He's laying in wait.
Are they going to go into blows?
And Suicydal Soulja through the the title, kicked it, hit JL Rose with that title belt. He's going up top. Wow.
The 630 senton.
He nailed it.
Wait, what just happened? The ref's still out.
The ref's still out.
But the bell just got rung.
We just had a 1-2-3.
Well, would you look at that? This match hit its time limit, and Suicydal Soulja and Jael Rose, neither of them come away with the victory as it ends in a mutual disqualification due to timeout. Suicydal Soulja is very not happy after hitting that 630 senton and seemingly assuring himself he'd have that title.
And wait a minute. JL Rose hangs on to the Pride title. By way, the match ended in a draw. The time limit expired. And the referee's still laying down in the ring. Referee Daniel Johnson.
We may need to get someone out for him because he has not been looking too good. But we have Paul Jordane and the Suicydal Soulja in the ring. JL Rose and Waylon Barley on the outside, reminding you somewhat of what happened at Fury.
Exactly. Flashbacks from Fury. And wait a minute.
Waylon Barley throwing the referee out of the ring, wanting nothing to do with him.
Just says get him out of here, tosses him to the side.
Hate this guy's guts. And I'll be honest with you, I really can't stand you either. Just
by Paul Jordane and Justin Michaels firing up. Wow.
Paul Jordane really making a bold decision. Jael Rose might have the opportunity to lose his titles, but Paul Jordane might have the opportunity to lose his career.
That's true. The career of Paul Jordane will be on the line. But interesting here, the dissension amongst the ranks of Untamed Defiance. A chink in the armor, perhaps.
What in the world is going on in your head? You sit there and grab that microphone and accept two matches in the same night for JL? Who the hell are you to accept two matches for the Pride Champion, for the Heavyweight Champion? He's already got Paul Jordane that night, and now you want him to face Trey Soulja earlier in the evening? What in the world are you thinking?
I'm the guy who believes in opportunity. I see an opportunity there. JL can take out Paul Jordane in one night.
That's all you care about?
I care about. I'm sick and tired of Jordane.
JL, look, I am so sorry. I have nothing to do with it, but I can't help what he's done, okay? I cannot help. He's already agreed to the match. It's already set. You're going to have to fight twice on the night, all right? But look, the bright side is if you can just, win, then Paul Jordane is gone forever. JL!
Yeah. He'll realize it.
Lenny, what do you mean? This is all your fault! JL!
September 9th, National Guard Armory. It goes down. My big bro, Paul Jordane, he put his faith in me. He put his faith in me and his career, me, that I could get the job done and take that Pride title once and for all. Jael Rose, I need you to listen closely. I survived you once. I survived you twice. And I know I can get the job done. And Paul, I won't let you down. This is what you need to understand. Jael Rose, I took your Pride mentally. And come September 9th, I'm going to take your Pride title physically. And I say, and the phrase goes, and I quote, every rose has its thorn. Jael Rose, your thorn is camouflage color. Tell me.
Jael Rose, September 9th, it's all coming to an end. Because the fact of the matter is, Suicydal Soulja, he's going to get his Pride Championship, and the endgame, Paul Jordane, is getting that NHW Heavyweight Championship on the line. I do not mind putting my career on the line, because I know for a fact He's going to do what he's got to do, and I'm damn sure going to do exactly what I need to do to leave there with the heavyweight championship, and it's going to happen. There's nothing you can do. September 9th at the Armory in Panama City, it's going to be a party that night because we're going to have a new Pride champion and a new heavyweight champion. It's coming September 9th. Please, please be there because it's going to be a good night for us.